Congrats! You made the right decision of having multiple speakers at your online meeting. So what now? My name is Christina, I'm from Slido, and by the end of this video, you will know what to do with your speaker squad. So if you are a meeting owner and are planning to run an online meeting with multiple speakers, here are 7 things to help you make your meeting a success. Create a single master deck for your meeting. Think about the last online meeting that you attended. How many times did you hear, "Can I start sharing now? Can you see my screen? Can you please stop sharing now?" It can be super annoying. To avoid these hiccups and unnecessary comments, we recommend create a single master deck. This will allow for a smooth execution of your slides and it will keep the nice dynamic of your presentation. Another great thing about having a master deck is that you'll actually be able to see how many slides your presenters have and it will put you in control of the presentation and in control of the timing. Invite a meeting moderator. This person acts as a bridge between your audience, the speakers, and you as the meeting owner. The moderator sets the mood for the entire meeting. He greets the audience, he shares the housekeeping notes at the start, and he guides you through the entire meeting. At the end, he can facilitate a Q&A session, and if anything goes wrong, he can save the day.
Wow.
A very important thing, decide about who is going to move through the slides during the meeting. Once you have created your master deck, decide about who is going to share the screen. This person will also move through the slides. The best thing that can happen to you, you are using a tool that allows for remote control. This way, you can give remote control of your presentation to the speaker that is currently presenting, and this person can then decide about when they want to move to the next slide. Change the speakers every 5 to 7 minutes. The best thing about having multiple speakers at your online meeting is that you can easily change the dynamic by simply changing the speakers. We recommend that you change the speaker every 5 to 7 minutes. That way, your audience will stay engaged and will keep their focus. Bring in everyone for the Q&A part. When you're running a meeting with multiple speakers, make sure you dedicate enough time for the Q&A part. Now, this is the time for your moderator to shine. The role of the moderator is to give everyone a chance to speak and distribute the time to answer the questions equally among all of the speakers. Alternatively, if it's just the two of you in an online meeting, make sure you take turns in asking and answering the questions. This will turn your Q&A into a natural and dynamic conversation. Agree on the communication channel. You are in this together, and communication is an essential part of the teamwork. So together with your team, together with the speakers and with your moderator, agree on the channel where you are going to communicate during the live meeting. It could be a WhatsApp group, it could be a Slack channel, it can be a group on the Messenger, you name it. The important thing is that everybody has access to it throughout the entire meeting and has notifications turned on for that channel. We also recommend that you invite your tech person into this channel so the person can monitor the situation and help out if anything goes wrong. Have a dry run before the meeting. Practice makes perfect. There are so many things that can go wrong during an online meeting. But the best thing you can do is to actually prepare for it. How do you prepare? Have a dry run. Invite the speakers, the moderator, and anybody involved with the meeting and run through the entire presentation. You can practice handovers from one speaker to another, who is moving through the slides, and get a general vibe of the entire meeting itself. You might end up changing the whole presentation or simply shortening or lengthening some parts of it. Trust me, from our own experience, dry runs saved many meeting disasters. To summarize, when having multiple speakers, start with a single master deck. Invite an online moderator, decide about who is going to move through the slides, change the speaker every 5 to 7 minutes, involve everyone in your Q&A part, agree on a communication channel, and have a dry run. So that's it for me today. Thank you guys for watching and fingers crossed for your online meeting. If you want to get inspired, watch our other videos on how to open a presentation or how to run a truly engaging webinar. And don't forget to subscribe. Bye.